wanted to give a quick demonstration of the virtual CDRW in action, so I'm going to use it to convert this album to MP3 format. First, I'm going to select the album, and from the File menu, I'm going to choose Playlist from Selection. That's going to create a playlist from this album. Once I have this playlist, from the File menu, I'm going to select Burn Playlist to Disk. You see the disk burner is the virtual CDRW and the format is audio CD. That's good to go. You notice iTunes is now looking for a blank disk. I'm going to go to the virtual CDRW menu and select New Media. Now you can see iTunes has recognized that a disk has been inserted and it's starting to prepare this playlist for burning to this disk. This is going to take a minute or two, so please be patient. Almost done. This is real time. I'm not editing this to speed it up. Okay, now iTunes is going to burn, so it's burning to the virtual CDRW. You can see burning to a virtual drive is very fast. It's done. The audio CD is mounted. Now we're going to import this audio CD to MP3 format. Again, very simple. Click Import CD. MP3 encoder. High quality. Of course, we could choose any encoder that we want. We could do Apple lossless, etc. But we're going to use MP3 for this demonstration. Click OK. We don't want to replace our existing tracks, so we're going to end up with two copies of the song, one in the original format and another in MP3 format. Now, as you can see, iTunes has started to read the virtual CD. Again, this is going to take a couple of minutes, but it is much, much faster to read a virtual CD than it is to read a real physical CD. And once again, I'm not speeding this up. I'm not editing this. This is happening in real time. Almost done, I know. Be patient. You can see the speed up here at which iTunes is reading each of these tracks. It's very fast. And the last track. Okay, so iTunes has finished importing everything. We can go back to our music library. We can look at the songs and we sort by kind and you'll see we have the MP3 and the original tracks. You can also see that the CD is still here. Well, we can eject that CD. At this point, the virtual CDRW will give us the opportunity to save this if we wanted to. We could save this and remount this CD later. Right now we don't want to save it, so we just click cancel. And we're done. All right, well, thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. And, start using the virtual CDRW to convert your songs to MP3.